going to start practice set 2.1. In this practice set, question number 1 is objective type. That in this question you have to decide for the given 3 number whether the numbers are Pythagorean triplet or not. So you can use the formula which I had given already to check whether the given numbers are Pythagorean triplet. Otherwise from the given 3 numbers, observe the numbers. In this 3 number, whatever is the greatest number, larger number, first you take the square of that number. So in this triplet, that is 3 number, 3, 4 and 5, 5 is the largest number. 5 square is equal to 25. Now the remaining numbers are 3 and 4. So we are taking square, sum of squares of that 2 numbers. 3 square plus 4 square is equal to 9 plus 16. Total is again 25. This square is also 25. And this total, square of total is also 25. Therefore, 5 square is equal to 3 square plus 4 square. Both LHS and RHS sides are equal. Therefore, the given 3 numbers are Pythagorean triplet. Second sub-question from question number 1. The 3 numbers are given 4, 9 and 12. Out of these 3 numbers, 12 is the largest number or greatest number. So 12 square is equal to 144. Remaining 2 numbers are 4 and 9. So sum of squares of the remaining 2 numbers, that is 4 square plus 9 square is equal to 16 plus 81. Total is 97. Now 144 and 97, both numbers are not equal. Therefore 12 square is not equal to 4 square plus 9 square. This LHS and RHS are not equal. Therefore, the given 3 numbers are not Pythagorean triplet. In this way, you are solving the remaining questions from question number 1 in your classwork notebook. Only 2 questions I had given the answer. Remaining question from question number 1, you are solving yourself. 2. In this question, triangle MNP. MNP is right angle triangle where this NQ is perpendicular to the hypotenuse. So whenever the perpendicular is drawn to the hypotenuse, then that segment becomes geometric mean. So in this question, we are using the theorem of geometric mean. So geometric mean is NQ square is equal to MQ plus QP. Because of this Q point, total segment MP is divided into 2 parts, MQ and QP. Therefore, MQ square is equal to MQ plus QP, and this statement is according to geometric mean theorem. Now, in the question, the values are given. So, we are putting the value of MQ and QP and finding NQ. MQ square is equal to 9 multiplied by 4. Product is 36. 9 MQ square is equal to 36. 36 is the perfect square of 6. Therefore, NQ is equal to 6. So here we are writing, taking square root. Question number 3. In this question, triangle PQR is given right angle triangle where this PM is perpendicular to hypotenuse QR. Now since perpendicular is drawn on hypotenuse, again in this question also we are using geometric mean theorem. So in this triangle PQR, PM is perpendicular to QR. Therefore, PM square is equal to QM multiplied by MR, and reason is geometric mean theorem. Now putting the value from the question, PM is given 10, so 10 square is 100. It is equal to QM is 8 multiplied by MR we are going to find. Therefore MR is equal to 100 divided by 8. Therefore MR is 12.5 unit. Now in question, QR you are going to find. So QR is divided into 2 parts, MR and RQ. Therefore QR is equal to MR plus RQ. Q, M and R, that is M is between Q and R. This is the reason. Now we are putting the value of MR from the question, that is 8. 8 plus 12.5, it is equal to 20.5. So QR is 20.5 unit. You are writing question from the textbook and then you are copying the answer from the board. I am not writing question also, and I am not given to find in this exercise because the space is very less. So that is why I am not giving. So please, students, you are writing questions from the textbook.